Hey, how's it going, everybody? So we're out here with this green venue, Hyundai, I think. But she's getting four tires put on it, so we got it all up on jack stands right now. All four tires off. We got them right here, just got them all broke free. So we're going to go ahead and get them all broke down off the rims. Where's my soap at? There it is. She's got four brand new tires here. We'll just go right down the row, right down the list. Kind of an oddball tire. It's a 15. We don't really do 15s that much anymore. Every once in a while. There we go. Throw that off to the side. Put that room there. Next. Oh, get in there. And that sensor up to the top. Come on, baby.
When you get thirsty, you come on in and I'll make you.
Oh, I got a soda here.
Well, no.
I got water on the back of my truck.
All right.
I always carry water on the back of the truck.
Oh, God, yeah. No, I understand that.
Yeah. All right. I have to have it for, like, soap and, you know, making up solutions and stuff like that. So I have to have it at all times. That was nice of her to offer me something to drink. Make sure I still soaked on the backside. Nope, that was not. Must have been one of the first ones that I broke free from the rim. I just used the bead breaker on the back of the truck. You know, on the tire machine that's on the back of the truck. I really only stand and use that tire machine and mount the tire on it during the winter time, so that way I'm not doing it on the ground like this in the winter. But I carry the tire machine in the back of the truck all year round, just in case I need it. The goal is to eventually get one of those, get a big enough truck where we can have a power tire machine on it. That'd be nice. Get in there, you. And if that doesn't work out, I'm thinking about getting maybe a trailer that I can pull behind the pickup truck. It's kind of like a mobile garage. We'll see. We got to get this little piece of property first, where we can get these vehicles out of my driveway. I got five company vehicles sitting in my driveway. Two motorcycles, a car, two pickup trucks. Well, this is one of the pickup trucks, the one I'm driving, the white one. Black one's my winter truck. four-wheel drive in that black truck works better than the four-wheel drive in this truck. Well, I don't know. Now that we got all the transmission fixed and the whole front end rebuilt and all that stuff on this white truck, I never even tested out the four-wheel drive now on this white truck. It should work just fine. Of course, this truck's just a pavement princess. And yes, you can call it that. The truck doesn't go all, I mean, it goes in the mud, but only when it has to. Hands. There we go. Okay. Now, like that. Set these out like so. Gotta get the pliers. Gotta get all the old weights off of them. I gotta get a knife to cut those free. That's why it's always good to carry a pocket knife in your truck. Just throw that in my truck, all these little plastic pieces. We'll get rid of those later. All right. Now, let's make sure they're not directionals and they're not, look at that. We don't have to balance. Rebalance. Got a yellow and an orange dot. Okay. Now, that makes a big difference. Flip them all over. Just like that. Now we just gotta line them up and put them on. No balancing. I like it. Just line up the yellow dot with the valve stem and go. People don't realize, though, is that the smaller the car tires, actually the harder it is to mount them on the rims, believe it or not. If you didn't know that. There we go. and we just walk it down. There we go. Just like so. There we go. One done. Well, one mounted anyways. Still gotta get it aired up. Got our valve stem straight up. Put our yellow dot straight up. Put it on the rim and push. There we go. I'm trying to get a little extra on is what I'm doing. Ow. There we go. Mashed my hand behind it. That was my fault putting it there. My hand. You. You gotta watch out for that too, because they'll go flying on you. I'm getting it. Get in there, you. There it goes. All right. Line up or not. Up on me. Gotta get in that spot here. There we go. Tired already this morning. It's warm out here already. But I don't know. What is that, 82 degrees or something like that? 78? It's about 80. I know that. It is warm. This side. Shoot. There we go. Come on, baby. There we go. Give me my step. Give me it back. Give me my spoon back. Stuck underneath the edge there for a second. Give me that. over there. Come on, baby. Come on. Come on. There we go. Come on. A little bit more. There we go. Okay. There's three. Move that one out of the way. Oh, I missed a weight on this one. Make sure ain't no more on this. Oh, yeah, there's one on this one. Must have had four on this one. Well, I only took it off of three rims. Probably. Okay. Like this, we don't have to worry about balancing with the dots on the tires. I love that. Wish all tire companies did that. That should be something that's standard, having the dots on the tire, where's the heavy part and where the light part of the tire is. Definitely. Yeah, it was starting on motorcycle tires, so people didn't have to balance their motorcycle tires. There we go. Today, I popped three times on the back side. Woo! Be check and see what the air pressure is supposed to be out on these tires. One done. Thank you. All right, there we go. That's all four tires done in under an hour, more like a half an hour. I'm going to get them back on the vehicle and get them torqued down, DS Vault, and we'll catch you guys in the next one.